great. So let's move on. All right. So this is the right eye, okay? The right eye. The right eye. Below. And this is the left eye. The left eye. Below. So my left eye and my right eye. Very good. Now, this is the visual field. The word you are seeing. Okay? So, visual field. Visual field. Visual field. Great. So, if I should stand here, and let's say close my left eye, I'm seeing with my right eye. So, the point or the areas or I'm seeing with my right eye is seems to be my right eye's visual field. And it can be divided into two. We have the images I see at the tempora and those I see close to my nose. Those which are to my tempora is said to be my tempora visual field. And those which are close to my nose are said to be my nasal visual field. Great. So it can be divided into two. My right eye visual field can be divided into two. Those away to the tempora is said to be the tempora or the right eye's tempora visual field. And then the one close to the nose is said to be the nasal visual field. So we have my nose there. I have my nose there. Right? Radio. Radio. Good. So this is my nose. So the one closer to my nose is the nasal visual field. And the one far away from the nose is said to be the tempora. Okay? So I can label here as tempora. Tempora visual field and my nasal visual field. Nasal. So here, yeah, close to the nose, nasal, afraid, tempora, okay, radio. Great. Great. Now, this is far to the right. So I can also say this one is called the left visual field. So this is far to the right. And this is also far to the right. Okay. And this is to the left. Okay, this is more to the left. This is also more to the left. Alright, so you have tempora, nasal, tempora. The ones that are close to the nose is said to be the nasal, and away from the nose is said to be the tempora, as I demonstrated earlier. Very good. Now, you are seeing that because of the refraction of the cornea, the image from the visual field turns upside down on the retina, which means that images from the tempora visual field will fall on the nasal retina. And in the retina, with my lecture 1 and lecture 2, I was talking about the layers of the retina and all that. I can just check it out and then see what is supposed to be in the retina. I have this ganglion cell, and the axon of the ganglion cell makes the optic nerve, okay? Great. So we have ganglion cells in the retina. And then the axon of the ganglion cell is called the nerve fiber. This nerve fiber leaves the eye, leaves the optic disc, and forms a bundle of nerve there, and the name is changed to be called optic nerve. So in the retina, we have ganglion cells in there. Okay, we have ganglion cells in the retina. Ganglion cell. Okay, radio. We have ganglion cells in there. Okay, and then the retina terminates at the ura serrata. Alright. Okay. So ganglion cells in there. Ganglion cells in there. Okay, the same thing happens to this side. Have ganglion cells. Ganglion cells. Ganglion cells. Great. Ganglion cells. And all the ganglion cells are terminating at the ura serrata. Okay, all the retina. The retina as a whole terminates at the ura serrata. Great. So this ganglion cells, they're having a tail. Okay. They have an axon, and the name of this axon of ganglion cells referred to as nerve fiber. They will leave the optic disc and form a bundle of nerve here, and the name will change to optic nerve. Radio. So let me represent. This is the tempora hemi retina. Okay, it is far to the tempora. You see the retina. The fovea serves as a landmark. We divide the retina into two. Okay, so basically take the retina. Okay. If you take the retina, okay, as a whole, we have the fovea over there, okay? And now the fovea is as a landmark. We divide the retina into two. So the part of the retina which is close to the nose, referred as nasal hemi retina. nasal hemin retina, okay? And what is closer or fused to the tempora, we refer to as temporal hemin retina. Hemin means it is half, temporal half of the whole retina, okay? Middle. So the same thing applies to here. So I represent those with the temporal retina with a red marker, and I'll represent those the nasal with a black marker. Alright, so the nasal, they will leave the optic nerve. This is the axon and ganglion cell, they leave the optic nerve this way, this man. Okay, great. Very, very important. So this is the nasal and retina, the retina which is close to the nose, okay? Nasal retina, very, very important. Alright, this one is close to the nose, so we have the nasal retina here. The nasal hemi retina. Nasal hemi retina, okay? Nasal hemi retina, which is close to the nose, okay? So this one too will leave the optic, this is the optic disc, and here we have no rust and cones at the optic disc. Very, very important. Great job. Have it this way. That way. Great. So this is one set of the optic nerve. Now, with the tempora, with the type of the retina which is far to the tempora, it's said to be the temporal hemi retina. We also have another one here. So I'll represent that with a red marker. So the tempora also leave, go this way. Temporal retina. The ganglion cells going that way. Very important. Okay. Alright. Wait. It seems to happen to this. So you have this way. Here and going this way. The axis of the ganglion cell also going that way. So here at this point we are having our optic nerve here. And you realize that the optic nerve is consisting of fibers from the temporal hemi retina and then fibers from the nasal hemi retina. I believe you get a point. Great deal. So you realize that this is the nasal retina and the temporal. The nasal retina will take information from the tempora, and then the tempora will take information from the nasal retina because of the refraction of the cornea. So you may just turn upside down. For instance, let's say if this is my marker, if my marker is here, instead of it to be on the retina like this, no. Because of the refraction of the cornea, so since this marker is here, on the retina, it will turn upside down to be this way. Very, very important. So because of the refraction of the cornea, the temporal hemi retina fibers will take information. This is the temporal retina fiber, the temporal, okay? Temporal hemi retina. So temporal hemi retina will take information from the nasal, okay? And then the nasal will take information from the temporal. Once again, because of the refraction of the cornea. Very, very important. Radio. Now, so this is black. I'll present here my black, which is the nasal will be taking temporal. Let's point. Alright. Great. Now since here is red, I also present here a red color. Okay? Great. Which means that temporal will be taking information from the laser. Great. The same thing happens to this one. So the laser is here. Okay. Great. And the temporal is here. Alright, so this is our T, representing tempora, and then our N, representing nasal, okay? Our T, representing tempora, and then our N, representing nasal, radio. So what this means is that the nasal retina will be taking information from, so it's like opposite. Nasal will take information from tempora, tempora information from nasal. So the nasal retina fiber, or the nasal hemi retina, will take information from the tempora, okay? So to go this way. So information will go this way, okay, and fall on the nasal retina. The same thing, the laser visual field information will form on the tempora. So you get it to go this way and fall on the tempora, okay? Very important, because of the refraction of the cornea. In the same way, here too, the same thing happens. You see, information from the laser will fall on the tempora. So this is the tempora laser, the tempora hemorrhoid now, okay? So the laser with red marker, it will go this way, okay, and fall here. So laser to tempora, because of the refraction of the cornea, I repeat, radio. Now in the same way, because of the refraction of the cornea again, information from the tempora also fall on the laser retina. So it means that when this laser retina is particular condition is emitted, it means that the laser side of the visual field will not be seen. So if these fibers are gone, it means that information from here will not be processed to the brain. Very important. Great. Now, since this is the tempora and the laser, so information will go to the laser again because of the refraction of the cornea, and to form here, and then to go through the series of biochemical reactions, and then it's just generating pulse to go to the brain. Alright, so here, you realize you have an optic nerve here, okay? So the whole of this is our optic nerve. So realize that the optic nerve is composed of fibers from the laser retina and the temporal hemiretina. The same thing happens to the left eye. Okay, so it means that when this black fiber or when this black side of the retina is gone, it means that information from the tempora, the left tempora, will not be processed. Now, with the lesions, your attention should be on the visual field. The lesions, your attention should be on the visual field, not at this point. So it means that now, this is the laser and the hemiretina, the left laser hemiretina. Which information is it taking? It's taking information from the tempora. So it means that when these fibers are gone, you won't see this side. But this is the optic nerve. So the black ones, okay, from the laser, they will tend to cross. So the laser, they will go this way. The fibers from the black laser will go this way. And instead of them to move on the same side, the laser optic nerve will not move on the same side. But they will tend to cross and go to the opposite side. So when I come this way, they cross, okay, and go to the opposite side. You get the point. Very important, very necessary. Okay, the same thing happens to this side of the retina. It is laser, so they also cross. So these fibers, the black fibers, also come this way, and also cross. You get the point? Radio. They also cross and come this way. Very important, very necessary. Okay? Yeah. Come this way. Okay? But with the red ones, which is the temporal side retina, the fibers come from the temporal retina, will move on the same side. By the laser, they will cross. But the tempora, you move on the same side, okay? So here you move on the same side, here you move on the same side, okay? On the same side. They will move on the same, they will cross, okay? On the same side. These are the fibers from the tempora, okay? On the same side. Radio. And the same thing happens to this side. The tempora fibers move on the same side. They will not cross, but the laser, I repeat, the laser cross. Okay, so they will move on the same side. Radio. Radio. Now, we have this retina. The retina is here. We have the optic nerve. Bundle of the nerve fibers, we mean the optic disc as optic nerve. And you realize that we have two sets. Okay, we have the fibers coming from the laser retina, and we have fibers coming from the temporal retina. Very important. Radio. So they will come here. So all these places refer to as the optic nerve, and the length of optic nerve is around 50 to 60 millimeters. Okay, radio. So now realize that the temporal side of the retina fibers do not cross, but they tend to move on the same side. But with the nasal, okay, fibers of the nasal move on the opposite side. So since they're moving on the opposite side, the nasal hemiretinal fibers move on the opposite side are referred to as contralateral. So these fibers are referred to as contralateral fibers because they tend to cross. So the laser refers to as contralateral fibers. Okay, contralateral fibers. And in the temporal fibers do not cross, they move on the same side. They are therefore referred to as ipsilateral fibers. So this refers to ipsilateral fibers. So they no cross. Now, you like that the laser and retinal fibers coming this way, the laser coming this way, and they cross. The point at which they cross, they overlap, is what we refer to as optic chiasm or chiasma. So at this point, where they are crossing, is referred to as optic chiasm. Or some people say chiasma. Very important. Radio. Now, after optic nerve, this is the optic nerve, this is the optic chiasm. Now, when you get to this point, you realize that these fibers are from both eyes. One is coming from the right eye, and one set of fibers also coming from the left eye. So at this point, we refer to this bundle of nerves here as optic tract. So it's from here to this point, okay? So we refer to this point as optic tract. Optic tract video. So it's from somewhere from here, okay, to this point. It refers to as our optic tract. Good. Now, with the optic tract, they terminate at lateral geniculate nucleus. Okay. So let's say we have our LGN here. This is our LGN, okay, video. It's our LGN. And the LGN is composed. Or it's of six layers. Okay, so the LGN is the LGN. LGN. We get a point. And they have six layers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they have six layers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We get a point. So they have the LGN here, as I was saying, okay? So with the optic tract gets to the LGN. But let me show you the particular place you can find the LGN. If you should go to the brain, okay? Let's say if this is the brain. Radio. This is the telencephalon, okay? Telencephalon. And this is the, you have diencephalon here. Diencephalon. Okay, this is the midbrain. The midbrain is here. Right, the pons and medulla. And spinal cord, So now, the LGN can be found at the diencephalon. And then in the diencephalon, we have a nucleus there called thalamus. We have two nucleus, so thalami. So we have one nucleus here. We have so many nucleus in the thalamus, so many nucleus. Okay, so we have two thalami in there. Okay, this way. And then the thalamus, there's a small nucleus attached at the lateral and both at the lateral and in the media. So, and then they are inferior to the thalamus. So we have one here and we have one at the opposite side of the thalamus. Okay. The same way we have a certain nucleus medially. So you also have one nucleus here and one nucleus here. But they are media. But the ones which are the lateral to the thalamus is referred to as the LGN. And the one and the media refers to the media geniculate nucleus. So the optic tracts get attached to the LGN. Okay, radio. Also, you have the thalamus here. Okay, radio. And have another one too here. Another thalamus here. Sorry. Another thalamus here. So you have a nucleus attached to the thalamus. Okay, to the thalamus. And you have another thalamus also here, okay, radio. You have also one attached. So this is the thalamus. So the nucleus here is referred to as the LGN. Another one is here, referred to as LGN. And then nucleus also is at the medial side, but I refer to them as medial geniculate nucleus. So what I'll do is that I'll bring this nucleus here. Alright, so let's say we have the midbrain here, okay? Let's say we have the midbrain here, this way, okay? This way. Great deal. So you have one thalamus here, okay. Great. And you have another one too here. Great deal. So we have the nucleus, the LGN, sorry, this is MGN. So you have the LGN, one NG LGN here, you have another LGN here. You get the point. So at this point, this is where the optic tract will get attached to. They all terminate at the LGN. LGN. The lateral geniculate nucleus, which is close to the thalamus. Very important. And the LGN is made up of six layers. So what I do is that I will pick the LGN and bring them here individually. And then we try to explain further. Great. Alright, so you have our LGN here, okay? This is our LGN. This is our LGN. They're made up of six layers, okay? Radio. So you have six layers. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Yeah, the same thing happens to this one. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the LGN. And this is the LGN. Okay? Good. But the LGN, 6 layers, fibers from, or the Ipsi, or the fiber, the uncrossed fibers will be received. So you have layers 1, 4, and 6. And layer 2, 3, 5. Layer 1, 4, 6 will be received by crossed or receive the crossed fibers. And layer 2, 3, 5 will receive uncrossed fibers. Okay? Uncrossed fibers. Radio. So which of them is the crossed and which is uncrossed? Now if you come here, you realize that the temporal head retinal fibers are not crossing, but they tend to move on the same side. So they are uncrossed. So 2, 3, 5, they will be received by 2, 3, 5, okay? So layer 2, 3, 5 will tend to receive on cross. So the red ones will go to 2, 3, 5. So the red ones will go to 2, and will go to 3, and will go to 5. You get a point. And then the cross fibers will go to 1, 4, 6. Cross fibers. Which are the cross fibers? Remember that the laser hair retina fibers, right, to the optic, and then you crossed. So these are which are the cross fibers. So they'll receive by 1, 4, 6. So the black will receive by layer 1, layer 4, and layer 6. Very important. The same happens to this one. These are crossed. Okay, you see they are crossing. So they will receive by 1, 4, 6. So the black ones or the lasers are like 1, and receive by 4, and receive by 6. And then the uncrossed will receive by 2, 3, 5. Uncrossed. We receive by 2, 3, and 5. Radio. Nine. Now after here, we have two sets of fibers leaving the LGN. Okay, so we have the ventral cortex over here. Okay, great. The ventral cortex. Have the striate cortex, Bodman number 17. They're the same name, okay? In the clinical setting, we don't just say Richard Cortex, they say Bodman number 17, and everybody tends to understand what the person is trying to mean. That is why we have different names for the brain, okay? Different parts of the brain. Radio. So now, we have, after the LGN, you have two sets of fibers. One is superior, one is inferior. Okay, and then right after here, we have what we call lateral ventricle. If you go to the brain, we have two. Okay, so we have the lateral ventricle here, gradial. So it is known to be this way. Okay, gradial. So this is for the right. Okay, we have another one too here. This way. Okay, this way. Gradial. Yeah, this is our lateral ventricle, okay? Lateral ventricle. So we have two lateral ventricles, but we have one third ventricle and all that. Okay, so I was saying there are two sets of fibers leaving the lateral ventricular nucleus going to the visual cortex. Very important. So we have one set of fiber this way. Okay, and then we have another set. This part, okay, gradial. The same thing happens to this one. We have one set, okay, let me do this way. So we have one set going this way, and we have another one too going that way. The same thing happens to this one also, okay. So we have one going this way, and you have another set of the fibers going this way, gradial. But you know one thing, this inferior fibers, the one here, you see, if they should go straight, they'll be blocked by the inferior horn. This is called the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. They'll be blocked by the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. You get the point, gradial. So because of that, they will tend to come down to dodge the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. Very, very important and very, very necessary. Okay, so they will come this way, okay, and because of the inferior horn, they will come down and pass here. Okay, alright, so this is the inferior horn, okay, so they will tend to dodge the inferior horn, come downward, and get to the visual cortex, okay, gradial, and get to the visual cortex, gradial. Now, the same thing happens to this one. I have the inferior one here, so they also dodge. So this one, inferior one, these fibers also dodge, right? Pass underneath the lateral ventricle and gets to the visual cortex, gradial. But here, they're in the parietal, so they will not get blocked. So they just go straight to the visual cortex. Very, very important. So with this one, they will pass through the parietal, okay? So they will go straight to the visual cortex, okay? These are to go straight to the visual cortex. Very important. Now, the fibers passing beneath the inferior horn, okay, are said now. But then, the fibers coming from the LGN to the visual cortex is termed as optic radiation. Optic. So these fibers are termed as optic radiations. Okay, optic radiation. Optic radiation. Gradial. Gradial. Now, these fibers are passing down the inferior horn. They are referred to as Meyer's loop. Meyer's loop. Okay, and then the one going straight without blocking is referred to as Bohm's loop. Okay, Bohm's loop. Bohm's loop. But then they are all optic radiations, which are an extension of the LGN. Okay, it's a nucleus. So therefore, it will have an extension. So the nucleus, the axon of the LGN is referred to as optic radiations or genicular current tract. Alright, so we have these fibers that are saying that they are going to the visual cortex and they are referred to as optic radiations or genicular current tract because you have calcarean fissure here and these axons are coming from the LGN moving to the area of the calcarean fissure that you have in the visual cortex. So it can either be called optic radiation or genicular current tract. So these arrangements of the whole visual pathway, very, very simple. Start from the visual field, going to the retina, optic tract, optic chiasm, optic nerve, optic tract, optic chiasm, LGN, and the fibers. So we are done with the arrangement, how they are being arranged. In our last lecture, we're talking about the visual defect, visual pathway defect.